Hello everybody, I am Ram Mohan. I am working as head of department at Government Polytechnic Mahabub Nagar for the Electronics and Communications Department section. The subject we are dealing here is the basic electrical and electronics engineering for the diploma first years. The unit we are looking into is the resistors. The subtopic of our current discussion for this session is the problems on the resistors connected in series and parallel. The objectives. Upon the completion of the session, you'd be able to calculate the equivalent resistance of the resistors connected in series and parallel and solve few problems on the series and the parallelly connected resistor network circuits. So it's combination as well. So it is calculate the equivalent resistance of resistors connected in series and parallel, then solve few problems on the series and parallelly connected networks of resistors. Let us recap the topics relevant to this and which we have covered in the previous sessions. When the resistors are connected in series, the total resistance is equivalent to the sum of the individual resistances. So it is given by the expression R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So we are considering three resistors connected in series. So let us see one example wherein actually there are only two resistors which are connected in series. So they are in series and there is a current of 5 milliamps that is flowing through the network of two resistors. And here the point to be noted is the current in all the resistors in the series network will remain the same. That is very important for us to remember. Then, what is the equivalent resistance when two resistors each of 1K are connected in series? How much it would be? Yeah, as per the above expression for R equivalent, it should come to 2000 ohms. That is 1K plus 1K equal to 2K or 2000 ohms. Suppose if they are connected in parallel, what happens? If they are connected in parallel, it should be half of that. So it will come to 500 ohms or 0.5K. Now let us recap further about the parallel circuits. When the resistors are connected in parallel, the total resistance is equivalent to R. So here we are indicating it with a blue color and that is expressed as 1 by R. So the expression for the equivalent of the resistors connected in parallel is as shown below. It is 1 by R equivalent or 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay. Now here you have a circuit in which there are two resistors connected in parallel and the value of these resistors is same that are parallel. So you have a current source or the source giving a 5 milliamps of circuit to the circuit of two resistors connected in parallel. Now you can see that the current is equally distributed because the value is same. But if they are different, the current has to be different and it will be different. And the point here to note is the voltage remains same across the parallelly connected network of resistors. So in series it is the current that remains same and in parallel connection it is the voltage that remains same. Then what is the equivalent resistance when two resistors each of 1K are connected in parallel? So it has to be how much? 500 ohms or 0.5K. Then what is the equivalent resistance when five resistors, each of R ohms are connected in parallel. It will be 1 by R plus 1 by R 2 plus 1 by R 3 plus 1 by R 3 plus 1 by R 4 plus 1 by R 5. But here the point is that each resistor is of only R ohms. So all the 5 resistors are having only 5 ohms resistance each equally. So it comes to R by 5. Okay, it will be 5 by R divided by 5. So that is the equivalent resistance of all the 5 resistors of 5 R ohms each when they are connected parallelly. Now let us get into some problems which are having a combination of networks, both series and parallel. This problem 1. Here the data given is a resistor of 30 ohms is connected in parallel with a resistor of 60 ohms. In series with a parallel combination, there is a 20 ohm resistor, and that is as shown in the figure below. So yeah, it's going to be there. Sorry. So there is a 20 ohms resistor in series to the combination of the parallel network, and then we are required to calculate the equivalent resistance of the entire circuit. So here is the circuit. You have two resistors, 30 and 60 parallel, and this combination is connected in series with a 20 ohm resistor. Now across the whole combination of parallel and a series resistor, we required to calculate the resistance, and the battery V is applied across the whole network as shown here in the figure. That's what we can see there. Now let us go for the solution. Now let us consider the first let us consider the combinational circuit that is highlighted with blue color now. So the given data is what? R1 is 30 ohms, then R2 is 60 ohms. Then you have the other resistor, that is R3, as 20 ohms. Then how to find R equivalent? So we need to find the first equivalent for this parallel combination. The equivalent resistance of the parallel combination is Re. I am using separating them for calculation purpose. So Re will be equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So that is 30 into 60 divided by 30 plus 60. So it is 1800 divided by 90, that comes to 20 ohms. So R equivalent in is, so this parallel combination, it is in series with the resistor R3. So let us calculate this. So 30 into 60 divided by 30 plus 60, so we are getting 1800 ohms divided by 90, that is equal to 20 ohms. Then this resistor is in series with the resistor R3, so the total equivalent network resistance will be Re plus R3. So this, that will be 20 plus 20, and the total resistance will be 40 ohms. So the total equivalent resistance of the network is just 40 ohms. Now let us look into a problem, second problem, where you have a circuit here. So you have here in the circuit, we need to calculate the total resistance and the total current also when a voltage of 20 volts is applied across the combination of the whole network. Now let us see this circuit. So here you have two resistors between nodes A and B which are connected in parallel, and again between B and C there are three resistors which are parallelly connected, and the value of this network will be 2, 3 and 6. So now let us consider the first network of parallel resistors, that is between A and B nodes. So there are two resistors, that is 3 and 4, connected in parallel. Now let us consider the 3 ohms and the 4 ohm resistor, that is the combination which is in parallel between nodes A and B. So here let us consider the network separately, the one between the node A and B, the other one between the node B and C. So here you have 3 and 4 ohms resistance, they are in parallel between nodes A and B. Hence the resistance we have to calculate between these two, and that is RAB here, and that is equivalent to 3 into 4 divided by 3 plus 4. So opposite resistance, yes, so it is 12 divided by 7, and you will get it as 1.7 ohms. Now let us look into the second half of the network. So that is the network between B and C. So here it goes. So considering this, the resistance RBC will be equivalent to this. So it is 286, so R1 R2 R3 divided by R1 R2 plus R2 R3 plus R3 R1. So using that expression, if we substitute these values, you will be getting it as 96 divided by 16 plus 48 plus 12, and that comes to 96 by 76, so equivalent to 1.263 ohms. So this is a total equivalent or R equivalent between the nodes B and C. Now we have to find the total equivalent, that is RAB and RBC. So now these combinations two are in series to each other. So by substituting the value of RAB, that is 1.7 ohms, and RBC, just now we got it as 1.260 ohms. So you are getting at a total equivalent resistance of the whole combination equivalent to 2.963 ohms. So this is what we have. And here we also have to calculate the current for the whole circuit when there is a battery of 20 volts applied across the combination. So we need to calculate the total current also, so that you will get it as this. So total current is equal to V by R A and C. So RAC is, just now we calculated as 2.963. So if you substitute 20 divided by 2.963 for the above circuit, so you will be getting a value of 6.75 amps. So this is the total current that the whole combination circuit is taking in or drawing from the 20 volts battery source. Okay. Now let us consider another problem. So here it is given as like this. There are two resistors R1 and R2 which are connected in series across a 100 volt supply. Then this series network is taking a current of 5 amps. And when they are connected in parallel across the same supply, they are taking a current of 33 amps. So we have to calculate their values. So for the solution, here it is like this. Now the given data is the supply is of 100 volts, and when they are connected in series R1 and R2, they are taking a current of 5 amps. But when they are connected in parallel, they are taking 33 amperes. So what are we supposed to find? We are supposed to find the value of both the resistors. Now let us consider the series combination of the resistors R1 and R2. Here actually we are assuming R1 and R2 as the unknown resistor. The total resistance is R1 plus R2 and the current here is R1 voltage divided by R1 plus R2, that is 5 amperes. So R1 and R2 will be equal to V by I, and V is 100, I is 5. So it is coming to 20 ohms. So this is the resistance of the network that is in series with parallelly applied voltage of 100 volts. So that is 20 volts. R1 plus R2 is the first equation. We are just keeping it aside. Now let us go to the parallel combination of the network, where R1 and R2 are connected in parallel. The total resistance RP is equal to, we have to find out, okay? So here the current is given as 33 amperes, the voltage is 100 volts. R parallel equivalent is equal to R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So the current is equal to V by R, that is coming to V by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So when you do some small transformations, you will get the value of R1 and R2 as equivalent to V into R1 plus R2 divided by I. So that is 100 is the voltage, R1 plus R2 is 20 because already we have that, and the current is 33 amperes. So this is coming to 60.6 ohms. So the value of R1 R2 product is 60.6 ohms. Now let us further go to solve the solution for R1 plus R2. Now R1 and R2 whole square is equal to R1 plus R2 whole square minus 4 into R1 R2. So R1 plus R2 is 20, so it is 20 whole square minus 4 into 60.6. So that is coming to how much? 157.6 ohms. And here it is R1 minus R2 whole square equal to 157.6. So R1 minus R2 will be the square root of 157.6. So that is coming to 12.6. Now R1 minus R2 is 12.6. So let this be 3. And you have R1 plus R2 equal to 20. So by adding these two equations for the value of R1 and R2, you will be getting, so here you add these two equations. So R2, R2 gets cancelled. So it will be 2R1 equal to 32.6 ohms. Therefore R1 will be equal to how much? It will be divided by 2. 32.6 divided by 2, that comes to 16.3 ohms. From the equation again, if you put this value into that, shall be getting R2 equal to 20 minus R1, that is 20 minus 16.3. So it comes to 3.7 ohms. So the value of R1 is 16 ohms and R2 is 3.7 ohms. So we got the value of R1 equal to 16.3 and R2 equal to 3.7. So this is the final solution for the given problem. Now let us summarize what we have learnt. So we have learnt the equivalent of R1 and R2 previously, R2 and R1 in parallel. And here we have also solved some problems based on the series and parallel combination of the networks. Now let us see a small quiz. If there are two resistors, 3 and 6 ohms, connected in parallel with a series combination of 1 ohm, the equivalent resistance of the whole combination will be how much? Choice A is 3, choice B is 5 ohms, choice C is 2 ohms. And choice D is none of the above. What should be the answer? It is 3 ohms. Now if you see here further, let us look at the frequently asked questions from this topic. A resistor of 10 ohms is connected in parallel with a resistor of 220 ohms. So that's a parallel combination. and again in series with this parallel connection there is a 30 ohm resistor connected. What is the resistance of the entire circuit? You can also consider one more numerical value problem. Find the values of the resistors which when connected in series give 25 ohms and 4 ohms respectively when they are connected in parallel. So it's just like the one we have solved of series and parallel combination networks. So with this we come to the conclusion of this session. Thank you very much, all of you. Thank you.